Installing Python on Microsoft Windows is easy enough if you only ever have one version of Python there. But when you add more than one version of Python to the mix, it gets complicated. The Py tool for Windows lets you choose which Python version to run among many installed, but it doesn't manage existing Python installations. It doesn't let you add them or remove them or make other changes. Now, all that is about to change with Python 3.14 and a new tool with it called the Python Install Manager. It eclipses the existing Py tool and lets you add, remove, or upgrade your Python installations from the command line. Let's check it out. Right now, the Python Install Manager is available in Windows through the Microsoft Store. It's still officially a beta product, although in my own admittedly limited use, it seems pretty stable. Once you install it, as I have here, it will replace the existing Py tool if you already have that set up. Now, when you open a command line and type Py, you're actually launching the Install Manager. If you don't supply any command line switches, it will launch whatever version it's designated as your default Python version, and that can change, so I'll go into that later. If we type Py help, though, we get this detailed options menu. If we want to run a specific version of Python from the ones available, we use the same syntax as before, py-3.12, for instance, to launch 3.12. Py list will give us a list of all of the available instances of Python in the system. You'll notice we have a number of runtimes listed, but they can't be managed through this interface because they were installed manually. In this way, any manually managed instances of Python can't be accidentally trashed through the install manager. Adding a new version of Python to your current setup is a one-line command, py install 3.11, for instance. And once you're done, you get information about where this version of Python has been installed. But again, you can always invoke it with Py by using a version tag. Now, if we do Py list, we now see that the newly installed Python is listed as one of our managed instances. And if we want to remove it, that's as easy as typing Py uninstall and the version tag. You'll notice we have Python 3.14 highlighted in the list of installed instances. That's because that's how I set this whole thing up, and that makes it the default version of Python according to the install manager. If I just type Py, I bring up that version. But if I want to change which version is the default, I can set an environment variable to do this. So in PowerShell, I'd use $env colon Python manager default equals 3.12. And once we've set that, you'll notice the default is now changed. And if we unset that variable, the default reverts to whatever version the install manager thinks is the suitable default. Again, in this case, 3.14. Now, I've only scratched the surface of the Python install manager's configuration options with this demo, so I encourage you to dive in for yourself and try it. If you're juggling many Python versions on one Windows system, it's going to be worth getting up to speed with how the install manager works going forward. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.